I came to the slightly sad conclusion a few years ago that my days of sleeping on my inch-thick inflatable mattress, as fantastic as it was, had come to an end because I'd wake up in the morning and not be able to move. So I switched to a Helinox cot, which I've used for the last few years and it's been very, very successful. At least I can get up in the morning. But it's still quite big, and whilst not heavy, it's still reasonably heavy and doesn't fit easily in a pannier. So I decided to try something new.
Okay, so here we're talking about the SeatoSummit Etherlight XT Insulated Mat. First things first, when you come to unbox it, don't do what I did and not check which end to open. It is clearly labelled. The rolled up mat is about twice the size of a coffee mug, and it's very light, only 560 grams for the large, down to 400 grams for the small. The carry bag opens at one end for the Airstream pump sack that allows you to inflate the mat without hyperventilating. But some more on that later. And the other end opens up to reveal the mat itself, and you'll get a very helpful repair kit, plus the bits you'll need to attach an Aero's pillow to the mat.
The way you inflate it is quite clever. So obviously when it's 4 inches thick, that's not going to self-inflate, and it's something you have to kind of do. You know, you're going to have to inflate it yourself. So what they've done is, rather than spending hours and hours and hours blowing up this thing, so if I let it, I'm going to let it out, some air out for a second. So you have this, but then it comes with this clever baffle. Now, you put this plug in, pull out the other one on top of it, which has a one-way valve. And this is what's very clever. So you put this in there. There's this thing that works with air, and they use it. They use it in some sailing things, but they use it in planes. You know when the big emergency slides come out of planes, they have a jet of air pushed in. But the reason they inflate so quickly is because the jet of air goes into the centre, and as it goes into the centre, it sucks air from outside in as well. So to do this, from a couple of little blows, the three little blows, and then look at all that air that's in there from three blows, because it sucks air in. And then what you do is you just push, and then that inflates your mat. And then because it's got the one-way valve, you just take it out, just do another quick. And then look, you've got all that air in it. You can also get it a lot more inflated than you can with your own mouth, because you're not having to go, you've got the power of your weight behind it.
How'd you sleep, Tom?
Really well, actually. Genuinely. It just sounds really cheesy if I say it's like the most comfortable sleep I've ever had, but it was. I don't sleep very well in tents, so I get a bad back and things like that. Because I'm used to quite a soft kind of mattress and sleeping on my side and things like that. But no, it was nice. I was chilly last night, but none of it was coming from underneath.
And you know what? I had just as good a night's sleep as Tom did. Woke up in the morning, no backache at all. And actually the following day, I was using it while camping up on Dartmoor. It must have been -3 or -4, and there was no cold at all coming through from the ground to my back. And in fact, I just woke up. I'm not saying I was feeling fresh as a daisy because it was absolutely freezing, but my back was perfect and the mat did a perfect job. And just as a final parting comment, quick size comparison with my Helinox bed. Now, half the size. Absolutely loved it.